What is all the hoopla about 1Password about? That's what we're going to find out in today's video. As a main user of LastPass who pays for their business subscription, I was like, why is everyone talking to me in these LastPass videos about I use 1Password? It's amazing. English is my first language, but it's surprising to me more and more that that's the case. Then when I took a look at this application, I went, oh, I get it. First and foremost, from a pricing standpoint, the business is $7.99 a month and the team starter pack is $19.95 a month, but that secures up to 10 members. So this flat pricing model is actually significantly better if you're running a small team. What you get for this pricing is apps for Mac, Windows, Linux, iOS, Android, and web. A very similar situation when it comes to all of the other accessories that come along with it. And something interesting about this is the fact that everyone gets a free family account for all team members if you're on this business option. And then when it comes to families, the pricing on this is pretty cheap as well, for $5 a month if you have a family of five. It also has a much better name to itself than things like Dashlane. Apparently, after I made the video about Dashlane versus LastPass, a lot of people informed me that Dashlane may not be one of the more secure ones. I guess that, I don't know, there's always conjecture on whether these companies use your data or not. I know LastPass is pretty safe in that sense. I usually trust people when like Linus Media Group says that it's fine. For personal use, you can see that there is $2.99 a month for just yourself. There's actually something interesting here where once you sign up into the account, you get an emergency kit. So basically, if you get locked out of your account, you need an emergency kit to sign back in, and it contains your secret key, which the company itself cannot access or recover if we lose it. I'm gonna just download this for myself. And then very similar to LastPass, it has a whole vault scenario. So if I go into my personal right here, you'll see that it has the 1Password account already put in here, the strength of the password, the website, and then the secret key associated with it. And then this is just some personal emails that you can put about people. So you can have different categories over here on the left. And there's logins, secure notes, and identities. And then there are also tags that you can associate with it. And you can see all the ones they gave me at the beginning are associated with the starter kit tag. Now, when it comes to the watchtower, this essentially gives you an overall password strength, breach report to look up your email address, and in the Have I Been Pwned database to see if any of my accounts have been compromised. And you could also check whether all of your websites have two-factor authentication, whether websites are unsecure, whether you have weak passwords, reused passwords, or passwords that are going to expire. So 1Password also has a Google Chrome extension. So if we go here to the Chrome store and add it to Brave, you'll see that it doesn't have the greatest rating, but it is very similar to that of the LastPass one, which has all the auto-generated stuff. If we go in here, pin this, all I gotta do is sign in, then I gotta drop this, and then now 1Password is ready to go. So now anytime I am on a website, if I go to sign in here, you'll see that I have a Chrome extension here. However, I will say that the load time on this guy is nothing to be desired. I'm not really too pleased with how long this is taking to pop up. Some recent reviews would say that it barely works. It's a quite useful extension to a good product and our organization relies on it, but it's quite buggy. However, we don't start like seeing so many of these so recently. Well, this is not actually one of the best things I've seen in a while. Like if I compare that to LastPass reviews, that's nearly 5 out of 5. Yeah, that's actually a big deal when it comes to the functionality side of things. I guess just showing here, this is exactly like what it is with LastPass, where you can have favorites, you can open up and fill things really quickly. You can sign into websites with a click. And just going back to this, let's try to log into something here. So if I'm going to go and go to the bottom here, I can add any of these different types of things, whether it be a login, secure note, credit card, identity, password, document, API credential, bank account. There is a litany of options you have here. Something that is underutilized about password managers is the fact that they don't have their website look at any of this. So you really can't put things like your driver's license, your documents, your passwords, your identity in there, and it is just as safe as you having them on any sort of shared drive, but in fact probably one step more than that due to the multi-factor authentication you can set up with these kind of things. Like LastPass, I always have to go in and basically approve it every single time I log into the dang thing, which for me it's like if I'm getting sensitive information, that's what I want. So let's try to sign up for a new example Twitter here. So if I put my name in and put down an email, what I'd really like to do here is set up a new password, but this Chrome extension isn't really working. So if I go back to LastPass, let's see if there is a password generator here. So if I do password, nope. Something I'm going to attempt to actually do is go to Chrome itself rather than Brave and see whether this fixes this 1Password issue, because I have a theory that it might. All right, so now that I'm in Brave, it seems to be working, which is kind of a problem considering Brave is the main browser I use. But anyways, if I go back into Twitter and make an example account, and you see I'm putting something in here, it can let me save this in 1Password. I can click on this. right here, just like with LastPass, and it prompts similar things to that, as well as what Dashlane does. And then here, what we're able to do is click on here and use a suggested password. And I can go here and you'll see that there's suggestions that pop up here. There's login options, there's identities here. And what you can do is you can actually make a new item and have a login, and it can add it this way, or you can use the suggested password and auto-generate it from here. Now you can do random passcode and change the character amount, change numbers and symbols, use default suggestions. Then you're able to paste this in here and save it to 1Password. And then you can put admin@riseproductive.com. You can even add a tag if you want and then save it. And then simple as that, you can set up new accounts and passwords. What are your thoughts on LastPass? Let me know in the comment section down below, and let me know what you think about this video and how to improve your productivity even more.